We're going to draw the Lewis structure for BF₃. The first thing we need to do is count the total valence electrons. Boron is from group 3A, therefore it's going to have 3 valence electrons. Fluorine is from group 7A, so it's going to have 7 valence electrons. Since we have 3 fluorine in the formula, we're going to have to multiply it by 3, therefore giving us a total number of 24 electrons. The next thing we need to do is arrange and connect the atoms. Since we only have 1 boron and 3 fluorine, we're going to place boron in the center and surround it with fluorine like this. And after that, we need to connect the atoms with 2 electrons. So we're going to connect boron and fluorine with 2 electrons each. The atom in the center is called the central atom, while the atoms on the outer part of the molecule is called the terminal atom. Boron in this case is the central, whereas fluorine are the terminal atoms. The next thing we need to do is to make sure that the terminal atoms are octet. To make our fluorine octet, we're going to place 6 electrons so that each fluorine will have a total of 8 electrons. Now that each of our terminal atoms are octet, we move on to the next step. We need to place any remaining electrons on the central atom, which is boron. Since we only have 24 electrons to work with, and we've already used all of them up, there's nothing left for us to place on boron. So we move on to the next step, which is to make the central atom octet. In this case, because boron is one of the exceptions, it is perfectly happy with just 6 electrons. It doesn't need to be octet. So therefore, we're going to skip this step. And with that, we're done drawing the Lewis structure for BF₃. Here are the 2 videos I've handpicked for you. Thanks for watching all the way till the end. If you find this video helpful, be sure to like and share it with someone. Don't forget to subscribe. Your support means a lot to me.